everybody. The weather is really looking nice tonight, as you can see from our Hyatt Regency camera. Okay, so let's check out what's happening. We do have a little bit of rain that's south of Pensacola. It's moving to the west southwest. I don't see this as a big factor. Then you can check out southeast Louisiana, south Mississippi. We look good, but an area of low pressure just off the coast of South Carolina is pumping moisture on shore with high pressure north of there. They've really got some strong winds, and that's going to be a factor for coastal flooding for them. Meanwhile, we're looking at this area of rain in the Caribbean. You know what? It's not looking like much, right? They are dealing with some strong winds aloft, also dry air. It's been the theme of this tropical season, which is a good thing. And look at these strong winds right here at the Yucatan Channel. So here's the deal. The forecast models have been taking this system north and then into the Gulf of Mexico. When you look at the Gulf of Mexico, not quite as strong a wind aloft. There is still some dry air, so not perfect conditions for tropical development. But the Hurricane Center is saying 20% chance for tropical development as we go out 3 to 5 days. What does that mean for us? Well, I think that we are going to have rain moving our way, but we're 2.5 inches of rain below average for the month, so we could really use the rain. Here is a look at the European model, and notice how it does have that stronger east-southeast flow. It's going to be a broad area of low pressure, according to the European model, but it could cause strong winds along the coast that could push water on shore and give us a little bit of coastal flooding. So what can we expect? As you go into your Monday, right now it's looking like east winds at about 20 to 25 knots. Seas offshore could be as high as 8 to 12 feet. You don't want to go fishing then. As you look at that persistent east wind, it could cause some coastal floodings outside of the levee protection system. And then our rain chances are going up for Monday and Tuesday. Here is a look at the big picture with that. Rain occurring right along the mid-Atlantic coast. Here we are, we're looking to the south, not looking like much. I'm telling you, Friday and Saturday really look nice. High temperatures in the upper 80s, only a slight chance of rain. But then as we go into Sunday, beginning to see this area of rain moving into the Gulf of Mexico. Now, this is just one model, but it does indicate a higher rain chance as you go into your Sunday. But for this weekend, partly cloudy and warm through your Saturday, a few more showers for Sunday, and then again, we're watching the tropics as you go into Monday and Tuesday. Look at Lakeview from Richard, just a beautiful sunset. Oak Harbor looks so nice from Susan Nye. And this is iridescence. You see that little bit of color that's showing up there? It's made by very small ice crystals or water droplets. And of course, a waxing gibbous moon. This one from Anthony Pollard. What's cool, it's 84% full. But as you go into Sunday, a full moon and a lunar eclipse, I'm just concerned that we'll have too much cloudiness. High temperatures today in the mid-80s to near 90 degrees. At the airport, a high of 89. The record is much higher, but the average 86. And then look at this, 79 degrees right now. So as we check out those temperatures, low 70s to the upper 70s, pretty nice out there right now. Morning low temperatures, mid-60s to the low 70s. And your high temperatures tomorrow climb into the upper 80s to even the low 90s. I think it's going to be a pretty nice day. Just a slight rain chance. 3 in the afternoon in the upper 80s. Then as you go into your weekend, your better chance of rain begins to develop on Sunday and then Monday and Tuesday. Higher rain chances, lower temperatures. Hope you have a great evening.